as a lawyer, I could never utter a word without standing. So when I became a judge for some time, I almost used to feel like getting up every time I said something. And I've gotten used to it over a period of time. And being a judge again, unlike being a lawyer where you need to come prepared with a particular statement and then give your exposition of what you want to say, as a judge, it's wonderful raising questions at all times without really being prepared. So I thought I'll take that privilege, yes, raise questions, my brother has raised questions, and I'll ask a few more questions of what comes to my mind. And I would expect that this debate will generate appropriate answers. There can't be a better occasion than having a chairman of the Law Commission being here. That you channelize all your opinions and things through him for better legislative activity at some point of time on a subject which is so crucial, so important. Actually, for me, it's almost a tempting thing to say that the judgment of the Supreme Court in Shreya Singhal in 2015, when they were examining, the Supreme Court was examining the constitutional validity of Section 66A, which was introduced, which contained provisions. On the face of it, would seem fine that any material, anything which is transmitted, which is grossly offensive, menacing character, causing inconvenience, annoyance, all this would seem a perfect legitimate areas for intervention and to prevent any such activity. But then the Supreme Court found how dangerous it could be if it is left to the state or administration to control without any guidance, without any legislative guidance of what these expressions meant. The Supreme Court judgment grew enormously from the experiences elsewhere in USA and other diverse jurisdictions and said that this provision cannot just be. When we examine this, I thought principally there are four actors. One, the individual whose freedom which you are going to be talking about. Two, the content and the entertainment provider, a person such as YouTube or the platform on which you have all this information available, or what you're seeing, or how you're able to ship your own material through this platform. The third one is the service provider, the internet service provider, which offers the platform for all these materials to be done. And the fourth one is the state, which literally controls, or which has the power to regulate what shall be available for the internet. I must say that what is correct, what is appropriate, what is acceptable, what is not acceptable, they change with times. And again, they change from country to country, culture to culture. What would be acceptable, probably if some of you students are watching John Oliver from a talk show in USA, and a Britisher who carries a popular talk show every week. He uses expressions, four-letter words, and expletives so easily in the conversation. Now, what so many lakhs of people are seeing, the tally is somewhere close to about 10 million every week. But then, what is acceptable then may not be acceptable here. So therefore, the judgment in Shreya Singhal also underscores that you can't simply transport one system of law from one country, one system of regulation from one country to another. We'll have to examine it in our own respective jurisdictions. I would just see there are three things at least which the debate now in the afternoon must help. One, it should consolidate the various opinions and formulate discernible codes of conduct for ourselves, so that we enjoy these freedoms adequately. We must identify, second, we must identify areas which require regulation and establish a protocol for exercising restraint only in order that fundamental freedoms which we like to express, they give rise to free flow of ideas that attain greater good. Third, ultimately, because like I said in the beginning, that with the Law Commission chairman here, we should be able to provide a roadmap for legislative changes which are appropriate, which provide certainty to what we want to regulate. That also would require to be seen. Now, what type of things, the problem, the freedom of expression and speech we confront in daily days, in daily life, we don't need to be looking for examples everywhere. You can just pick up a day's paper and find out, and you will find there is appropriate fodder for what we are looking to solve, or what the problem is, how is it to be seen. Just as today was in news, some of you must have seen, there was an engineering college student in Bangalore. He had been posting some a meme on the actors, Karnataka actors. It was in the context of the government and the actors and actresses in Karnataka carrying out public protest against the Supreme Court decision directing what the government would not like to do. The government would be using euphemisms. We don't disobey Supreme Court. We are only expressing problems which we can't believe so much about it. This was a boy who put in a blog of what he thought was how the actors are doing. He was therefore trying to carry out some caricatures and then posted it there with the Facebook. I believe some of the students were saying, some of his own classmates were saying, don't do anything like that. This boy was picked up in the college and then beaten up black and blue. You must see, it was shocking to see in the net. The persons who make the beating for this boy have no sense of shame about taking the whole photograph and then upload it immediately. It's all available for being uploaded. Who prevents it? And they don't want to even conceal their identity or anything. They're declaring, now look, if you're going to be saying anything against what we think is correct, this is what will happen to you. So therefore, a freedom of expression of what one believed to be appropriately expressed and what he could do in his own site, he knew immediately. He had an access to so many lakhs of people. So many thousands, so many people can immediately. If I need an audience, I need to come to an invited place and I'll probably see about 200 persons. Not a person who posts something in the Facebook. He can put it up somewhere and then expect so many persons to see. That is the kind of power of the internet, what is the internet age provides. So this is probably about 11 questions were formulated by the government in Shreya Singhal. I'm not going through that because it's there available in the public domain. How it is important that different system of regulations obtain and how the freedoms get to be expressed in ways which are powerful. And that is what the judgment examines. So here is the case, therefore, of one person who believes that he has a right to say anything and is foolish to post it there without minding the consequences. If what he did was correct and law must support it because the constitution provides for a fundamental freedom of expression, then what is the level of protection which the government can give? In fact, not even a complaint, the paper reports today that not even a complaint was registered against those perpetrators. Their identity is not very difficult to search. There is yet another thing which has come today, again, of what you see in the paper, not today, probably sometime back, which every one of you must remember. This was again about college students. I'm there in a college place. Therefore, I know how you look at things. Therefore, what you should be guarding yourself, what you should be guarding yourself against. This is about a girl who made merely a thumbs up sign to, I approve, I like it. That's all she did. To a piece placed on the wall in the Facebook, saying that one particular political person is also another man who was born and died, who died. What is all the fuss about one? This happened in Maharashtra. A person who was born must die. Nothing is more certain. Birth is even can be uncertain. Whether a person is going to be born or not could be a matter of uncertainty. But every person that is born is dead. So that is the surest thing. For a person, for a state to completely come under, clamped under a hatal, forced hatal, there is a girl who felt nothing more than wrote in four lines. If a person is born, and every person is born and dead, it's all the natural thing to happen. Why all this fuss? And this girl signed thumbs up. These two persons, they wrote a complaint, the leader of a party made a complaint and did not stop with the complaint. All these persons went, he collected the hooligans of about 200. Went to the girl who put her thumb up and yet another girl. They went to the houses, ransacked all the belongings. And here again, these two girls were arrested. Look at how a state administration would act in a case where A person is putting something or what he thinks is correct, his own opinion. He was not even criticizing anyone. He was saying, now what is the fuss? And they get arrested. And the persons who beat up or who burn up things, nothing, no action is taken. Now, these are serious areas. When we are talking about your constitutional freedom, then you realize that the person, the administration which controls or which can protect, if they don't protect, they don't protect because of political exigencies. The person who creates a problem, who creates an issue there, if the person belongs to their own party, therefore the state administration will not act. Or if in the ethical case where somebody is doing something wrong, is not protected, that person will not be put. And now again, see in today's paper, I'm not making a political issue, but I'm merely saying, flagging some of the things which we keep seeing. And therefore I say that there must be some need for some guidance. Whether a particular television channel must be blacked out for a day or not, on an issue of what they see as whether it is a national security issue or not, itself is a problem for us to identify what is national security, what can be put up or not. We don't have definite guidelines, or could it be left to so much of subjective appraisal of what could be national security? Or is it not necessary that we have a sure guideline on this? So I would like to believe now, even as we are talking about the fundamental freedoms, we all know that it comes with a tag, that it has to be so expressed that we don't trench upon anyone else's freedom. We do not trench upon anybody else's privacy. Now, the internet users, if they think that they have a wide audience and we can go on anonymity, post anything, may not happen. These days technology is sufficiently strong to identify who is the person who is posting, where is the person from where, which is the place from where this information is coming. All that will be possible. So therefore we need to create an environment, even among the community of students from this time onwards, to state responsibly of what you get prepared through your colleges at various times and moods and things, how to dissent in a respectable way. How do you express an opinion which is not a popular opinion in a way which is appropriately decent and civil? Freedom of expression must be always understood as how, if you don't want to say what is popular, how when you dissent, how to say it respectfully. Or if a person holds a view which is not in the way you think, how you dissent from that view, what you see in courts daily, what you get prepared in colleges, must be reflected in so many other places as well. Because internet, half the time I wouldn't know how to use even an internet. But then I know my son does better, or any one of you does better. Your usage is more. So therefore you need to know what are all the things which come along with these freedoms. And again, we need again appropriate guidelines for these entertainment providers. For I knew myself, it came before me when I was doing a case of a suit filed by a film producer against Google, saying against YouTube. YouTube probably is Google's platform. So therefore it was against them, saying against an American company in Chandigarh, saying that their film had been uploaded there, there was a copyright violation. On the first day of hearing, Google said that we have withdrawn that. In a normal understanding of law, whoever causes a reproduction without proper sanction or license, he will also be guilty of copyright violation. Now, here is Google saying, now we will upload anyone, we will not check at the gate of what gets uploaded. We will allow anything to be brought in, but then if anyone objects and then we have verification that there was a copyright issue, we will withdraw it. That is good enough for compliance. They had their own terms and conditions which they were trying to support. So therefore you know the normal copyright law of what would be understood previously may not be understood the same way in the internet age. We'll have to probably look at it differently. Of what time you can contest, what time the violation takes place, how is the reparation then? They need, therefore, an appropriate guideline, a protocol of what is to be done. How do they act as responsible gatekeepers? This is, again, probably a challenge which would require to be addressed by appropriate regulations, appropriate guidance, appropriate terms of use. And the state, all things must be wedded to the core value of freedom of expression. This is the most important thing, that the state must believe, the party in power must believe that this freedom must be protected at all times. It's too precious. It does not require any great explanation why freedom of expression is sufficient. All that we have gone through, the fundamental rights of how it has, the ideas of what, the exchange of ideas, how it has helped the societies to grow, everyone understands. And therefore, we will expect the government to be responsive to people's aspirations and expectations. And how do we make that government work? How do we make the government accept this as valuable? This is again an important democratic expression of how we expect the government to respond to people's aspirations. How this will all be done is how we expect, what I believe are important questions which our panelists will address before. Thank you very much for this opportunity to open this up.